In this video, we'll show you how solar panels are securely attached to a shingle roof to prevent leaks and roof damage. All right, Larry, so what are the different types of methods used to install solar panels on a shingle roof?
So, Warren, there's two primary methods. One is the flashing method, and you can find a video with more details about that right above. And that method is you pry up the shingle,
yep.
And then you put a flashing in. You probably put some goop around where you're going to have the hole. You put a flashing in, and then you run a lag bolt right down into the rafter. So
right. That's
been the common method ever since I can recall in the solar industry, very, very common method. Now, there's a newer method that's just come out. IronRidge has come out with their device called their HUG attachment, which we're really excited about. I think it's pretty cool for a variety of reasons. One is that newer shingles, in order to separate them, the slide and the flashing, you almost have to rip them apart.
Sure.
Destroy them almost. And so there's no great way to do that for really new roofs. And so this eliminates that issue. And what you do is there's six holes for screws, three on this side and three on this side, and you center this over your rafter. And then you run a screw through the center hole, another screw through that center hole, and if you hit your rafter with those two screws, you're golden. You're good to go. You're done. If you miss the rafter wasn't quite where you thought it was, you can run a screw through here and here, and if you hit the rafter there, again, you're good to go. If you miss it and it's on this side, you can run two screws through there and you're still good to go. All you need to do is get two screws into the rafter, or if you miss the rafter completely, you can just put six screws in and have it deck mounted right to the decking of the roof. So it gives you a lot more flexibility. Before, with the flashing, if you missed the rafter, you had to pull the lag bolt back out,
yep.
Try to seal it up, try to make sure that it's waterproofed and all that. This, you don't need to do that. If you miss the rafter, there's other ways to do it. This has a sticky butyl at the bottom. If I peel that off a bit, you can see it. That
yep.
sticks to the roof. And what that does is it fills in every nook and cranny of the roof, so you can't have any water get underneath there and get into the holes, into the penetrations. And then it has a thin layer of foam right in between there. And when that foam gets squeezed, it becomes... Yeah, I'll do it here. When that foam gets squeezed, it becomes completely waterproof as it compresses. So when it gets hot and cold, there's nothing moving around, it's compressed and right there against the roof. So a pretty cool solution that we've really come to like really well.
Will installing solar panels void your roof warranty?
Yeah, it's a good question. I mean, you think about it, you're putting potentially hundreds of holes all over your roof.
Right.
I would say that's a case-by-case situation. In your situation, you might want to reach out to your roofer. You might want to reach out to your manufacturer. One of the things that we really like about IronRidge is they do a great job of researching this on their own, reaching out to manufacturers. Some of the manufacturers actually provide a letter that say that this is an okay solution and won't void your roof warranty as long as it's installed properly. But that's something that will need to be researched on a case-by-case basis.
If you're a business leader or homeowner and want to see how solar can help you save more of your hard-earned money, visit paradiseenergy.com to request your free custom quote. In addition, our website is full of calculators, blogs, buyer's guides, and more, all designed to help you on your way to a successful solar investment. Thanks for watching, and click here to watch the next video.